Okay, let's think about integration testing, and this is also done with test-driven development. So we first write tests, and then we think about writing the actual code. Now I have a task that we want to build a system that there is a person class, a house class, and key class. So person can use his key to lock the house or unlock it. So that's the task. And another person with another key cannot lock it, or a person with unlock it, or person with another key cannot unlock it if it's locked with one key. So these are the key components of this program, and then we want to write some testing there. So let's start with key. The key, it has only basically some kind of a ID value, so we really don't need any big tests there. Let's skip that and build a person for person some kind of tests. So now there is this ID. This means that it's integration testing. And then there are this house. We can also create tests for that. So I'm clicking this integration test so we can get this integration here. So now we have all the test classes, so we can start implementing this. So let's go with the person. Test person, let's test it like this. So let's create a new person. Then we want to give it a key. Like this, and now there are way too many. Yeah. Like this. Now it's okay, and if we of course don't have this kind of a variables because we haven't written those classes yet. Now person has a key, and then person should be able to lock the house. So let's create a house. Like this, and then we want to lock the house. Okay, so we need to check now that the house can be locked. So let's test it like this. So house lock, and we get the person to lock it. Then we really test this like so is the house locked? It should be locked, and then we can unlock it. And it should produce false. Then we can have a new key. Maybe we get the old key too. some kind of a test variable. Like this one, and then we create a new key. And we set that for the person, we give it to he give the key to it. And now we then try to try to lock the house with the key, the new key, and it should fail. And oh, let's see, it's unlocked now. We can lock it with the new key. So let's first lock the house here, and then we try to unlock it with a new key, and this should return false because we cannot unlock it with another key. So now we are integrating a person class, key class, and house class in this test, and let's see how they are doing. So now we run the tests. Of course, this will fail. There's a compiling error because we don't have all these things. So let's start building them. Let's first begin with the key. Key is very simple. We only need a constructor there, and maybe a well, we need first some kind of an ID. That key needs to have an ID. And then we need a constructor that is setting that. No, it's not setting it because we are randomly generating there some kind of a key. Like this, and rand next int. Can have a very big integer there. Let's import the random library. So now this key can open and close the door, and we need some kind of a get there for that ID probably. Let's get that one. Yes, we have no way of modifying this ID, this key. This is always the same key. Of course, if we are just getting a random number, we could end up in a situation where we have two similar keys. So this is not secure, but it's enough for this example. Then we have a person class, and the person should have the key like this one, and nothing more. We can just generate a constructor, and then we get the setter and getter for this key like this. Let's see. Then we have the house class, which has some kind of a way to get it if it's locked or not, and we need to have also a method to what I'm saying. We should have a method to unlock and lock it, and to get status if it's locked or not. And of course, the house needs the lock in house needs to be able to tell what is the correct key. So let's put a variable lock there, which is the same as the key ID, so then it's locked with that kind of a key. And then we need some kind of a methods for locking and unlocking. So there was this person coming to lock it. So then we can just ask get key, and the key itself has the get ID, so get ID, and this is put to the lock. So now the door is locked, and then we need to have a let's generate another method that unlocks the door. And yes, we need to have some kind of a variable. Or no, let's see that the lock is -1 when it's unlocked. Now it's locked, and when we unlock it, we can unlock it only with the correct key, so we need to check that. So if the lock is the same as the key ID, then we can unlock it, which means that we set the lock to be -1. And then we need a method that it's giving the status. So it's giving a boolean value, is locked, and this is only returning the return. So if lock equals -1, then we are returning false, autofi true. Let's see how is this thing now working. So there is a way to set key that is not implemented yet. Let's see. Yeah, it should be get key. Why it was only K? What the hell? And house, we have a key 2 here. It's good that we have those tests telling us that there are some problems. Okay, now we could run the test. As these tests are integration tests, so these files have this IT here. They are not run if you are running the test project. So it's not running, but if you are running a test file, so then it's running this integration test, and now we can see that it failed. Let's see. Expecting false, so it's here or here, and it's actually this last one, because now we here lock and try to unlock with it another key. Then it should be still locked, so this should be true. Here is a mistake. And if we now run this file, then it says that this testing is okay. And actually this test code should be here, because we are now doing the integration test. So let's see. Now the test is passing. So we have created the integration test that uses three classes: person, house, and key. And the person can have the key, which is then used to lock the house, and it can be only locked, unlocked with the same key. So now we can actually test this with an additional test. So we have the old key there. Let's create another person. Like this one, and now the person 2 needs a key. Let's set him new key, just a random key, and that key cannot be used to unlock the door. So let's put this second person, and now is it locked or not? It should be locked because that key could not be used to open the door. And then let's give this old key that is the key that works. So then this is locked, should return false because the door is open. Now we can test it. All the tests have been passed, so it's working like it should. Yeah, this was it. This is how we can do integration tests, integration testing with NetBeans and